As we have set up MongoDB successfully, let us go ahead and validate by performing some basic database operations. Before actually performing any basic operations, first we need to ensure that MongoDB is started without any issues. As we have used MSI to install MongoDB on our Windows-based machine, whenever we restart the machine, MongoDB will be started automatically. And hence, first we can actually validate whether MongoDB is started or not by just running Mongo command here. If Mongo command take you into the CLI without any exceptions, that means the MongoDB server is started without any issues, and hence we can start performing basic database operations using this Mongo CLI. Now to list the databases, we can say show DBs, which will actually show all the databases that are there. Admin config local comes as part of the installation itself. They are system databases. Testing DB is the one which we have created after setting up MongoDB along with Compass earlier. We also created a collection using Compass. To actually list those collections, we have to first switch to that database. So we can use command and say testing DB here, and then we can say show collections to list the collections. A collection is nothing but a group of documents. So when it comes to MongoDB, we refer each element as document and group of documents as collection. We don't use terms like table and rows. A RDBMS table is similar to MongoDB collection. A record in a table is similar to a document in the collection. However, when it comes to document, we have concept of nested documents and all those things, which are not very common with respect to regular tables in RDBMS. That being said, now to create a new collection, you can actually either use create command, or we can just say DB. DB is nothing but an object pointing to our testing DB, because we have said use testing DB. So using DB, either we can create a collection by using create command, which is kind of a DDL operation, or we can just give a collection name, let's say demo, and then on top of this collection, which will be created when we insert our first record, we can invoke an API called as insert, or operation called as insert, and as part of the insert, we can pass a JSON object, and that JSON object will be inserted into this collection called as demo. So here we can specify the JSON in curly braces. Let's say the key of the first attribute of this document is name, and let's say name is nothing but Scott Tiger, and another attribute we want to insert is nothing but department, and let's say it is nothing but sales, and hit enter. Now you see that a row is inserted into this collection by name demo. Now if I say show collections, it will not only list the testing collection, it will also list demo. Now if you want to insert another record, let's say John Blake, you can do so, and you can hit enter. Another record will be inserted into this collection. Now to get this document from the collection, we can actually say db.collectionName, which is nothing but demo. Then we can either use find one or find. Let's use find here. You can pass a query in the form of JSON, which we'll be seeing later. For now, I want to see everything. So I can just say find like this. And I want to see the results in a bit readable fashion. For that, we can use a function called pretty and hit enter. Now you see, you got both the documents that are inserted into the collection whose name is demo. Even though we have used only name and department to insert, it also created a unique ID for each and every record inserted, and then it actually inserted into the collection. We will actually talk about this unique ID and all at a later point in time when we get into the CRUD operations with respect to MongoDB. That being said, we have performed some basic operations such as inserting data into a collection, which actually take care of creating the collection itself, and also how to read the elements from the collection. Now, if you want to see all the operations that are available on top of collection, we can just say db.demo, which is nothing but collection name, and then dot and hit tab. It will actually list all the APIs that are available on top of the collection. We can create indexes on the collection. We can drop indexes on the collection. We can delete rows from a collection. We can perform count, we can get distinct elements from a collection, so and so forth. There are n number of operations that are available on top of our collection. Similarly, if we want to get operations that can be performed at database level, we just have to say db dot and then hit tab, and you can see all different type of operations that can be performed on database. We can create users, roles, we can drop the database, we can drop roles. We can create collection, which can be empty by using db.createCollection rather than saying db.collectionName.insert. If you just want to create a collection which is empty, we can use this create collection, so on and so forth. So there are n number of operations that can be performed using DB. That being said, so far we have validated our Mongo installation by performing simple database operations against MongoDB. We'll actually get into detailed overview about CRUD operations in MongoDB at a later point in time. For now, this is good enough to move on and take care of setting up IDE called as Robo3T. And also we need to set up datasets so that we can explore MongoDB in detail and also understand how MongoDB can be used while building applications.